Give them a VA, Virginia is for Lovers, warm welcome for Incognito and Maysa.
Thank you. are so glad to be here sharing these moments with you, because music is the thing that brought you and us together tonight. The love of music. And every band that plays, for us to be able to share the stage with such great people, wonderful musicians, beautiful spirits. I was out there listening to Eric singing, and that falsetto was so sweet. I was like lost, and that blew my mind. Great singers come into our lives, and they become the soundtrack, the sound that we gravitate to. I was looking for a singer in the early 90s, and I put out a call to America. Please, anyone who knows a great singer, let me know. And in those days, you didn't get Google. You didn't get, you know, can't watch somebody on some kind of YouTube. None of that. So you had to rely on the recommendations of the people, because by the time they sent you a cassette or a tape, you'd be kind of like maybe a month down the line. I needed a singer straight away. And they gave me a long list. And my criteria was, who do I get? I don't know these people. So I wrote back saying, which is the less diva-like?
Come on now.
Which is the sweetest person? Who has that beautiful heart? And I put in a call to that person. And I asked them if they knew the music of Stevie Wonder, because I'd recorded a tune and I wanted them to sing it. And I heard a giggle come back. I'm working with him. I'm actually recording. And it was this beautiful lady with not a voice like I just made, much, much nicer, much, much sweeter. And it spoke to my heart. And she came to London and recorded with us. The one and only, the beautiful spirited, the wonderful Maysa.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That's my girl right there. So you could imagine how my mind was blown. Because I'd spent my life, since I was 5, been writing songs. And during my teenage years, I had pictures of Chaka Khan on my wall at boarding school. The boys wanted to always borrow that picture, I don't know why. So, easy. And I was always thinking one day I would have a band and I'd find a singer that had that quality of voice, like an Aretha Franklin, like a Chaka Khan, you know. But they come rarely, and when they come, they blow the world away. And I think, for me, personally, we've got one here. Maysa, please, one more time.
He's from London. He looked like a little farmer from Iowa.
Sound to
Rocco leaving because you see Maysa walking off the side. She'll be back.
Yay!
Yeah. Something about the water.
Yeah.
What? What are you guys... What are you guys giggling about? Yeah. I'd like to introduce you. You heard her with Eric, singing with Eric earlier. She features very heavily on an album that I've just been producing for the band, which comes out at the end of summer. Cherry. CHERRIV. Cherry V. Station, I'm going to take you for your interview. And I thought, oh, she's the interviewer, she looks lovely, and she's given me a warm greeting, so I felt really good about that. Then she said, oh, would you like some coffee? And she went off to get me some coffee, and I was interviewed by another person, and I felt that was such a warm greeting. And I found out that she's a singer, and when I heard her voice, it blew my mind, and I made her a promise. I'm going to send you a soundtrack. I'm going to send you a backing track for you to write to, because not only did I like what she was singing, but what she was writing. The one and only Deborah Bond. You know, during the pandemic at the height where people were just locked inside their doors, I've been working with a lot of broken people. That their minds were not in the right place, and there was a lot of children that were suffering. And I would send them that song, an MP3 of that song. And I would have meetings with Down syndrome children, and they would be singing it with me. And this meant so much. So thank you, Deborah, for that song, because it's a song of hope and life. Thank you. So yeah, just one thing. Everybody in here has a year that defines them.
Yeah.
What year is yours? My brother took it. 1989. 82. 92. What? 62? No, no, you shouldn't be here. I'm just joking with you, but mine was 1975, as is this brother here. I went to see Santana play. Yeah, wore the t-shirt, Santana, the hand holding the dove. And I walked to the Hammersmith Odeon. Santana! But what's this? Opening act, long name. But you can't be rubbish if you call yourself the elements.
Yeah.
Earth, wind, and fire. I became a disciple. From that moment, the moment they took to the stage, one man wearing a white suit beneath a white light, and his name was Morris White. And ever since that day, I've had guitars, keyboards, bass, drums, singers, percussion, the full rig, because I'm a disciple. This is 1975, the story of my life.
It's a good year.
Okay.
It's a good year.
To crawl, we had a fight.
So in this life, we meet people. They become our friends. We start dating them, and we marry them, or we spend good times with them. We go into work, we make friends. Then we leave that job, and we no longer see them. Why is it that when we break up, we become enemies? Why is it that we can't remember that we were friends, and that's where it started, as a friendship? Get back to being friends. Life is too short. Still a friend of mine.
Oh, I heard the song.
Those trees are Thank you.
today. I wish. These are my babies. These are my life source when we travel on the road. I need that every night. It's different every night, and the energy, but it's the sound of the drums. It's the beginnings of music. It's the first music ever played, a stick and an animal skin. Boom. There you go. Hit something and it goes into this. From Rome in Italy, Francesco Mendolia on the kit. From Macau in China, Joao Caetano on percussion. Representing Jamaica on the four strings, Francis Hilton on the bass. From the island of Sicily, Kiko Alotta. One of the finest guitarists in the world, we're so lucky to have him in the band. From England, Charlie Allen. On saxophone from the USA, Carl Cox. From Scotland, Sid Gold on trumpet. From USA also, Paul Abergast on trombone. From the island of Mauritius, if you don't know where it is, go look for it in the Indian Ocean near Madagascar, off the coast of South Africa. It's a beautiful island, it's my island, and if you go there, just say, don't say Bluey, say Jean-Paul Monique is my friend, and you'll have everything for free. Not really. So, there's a time in a songwriter's life when suddenly magic happens, if they're lucky. The magic came from meeting Maysa. The real strength of the relationship was that we could talk to each other. And she told me her business. Don't tell a songwriter your business unless you want people to hear it. And I wrote her a letter to warn her about a member of my group back then that I could see she had eyes for. And one night I found her by the window as he drove away. The lyrics came to me and I wrote the letter, but then I turned it into a song. And my Lord, has it worked around the world. But most importantly, it's been a part of our lives and given us this opportunity to play, especially here in the States. Thank you for your voice, Maysa, and thank you for sharing your story with me.
Going out of my mind.
When I see you, the audience, this is not just for us, for every band, but the fact that you want to sing, the fact that you want to embrace music, the fact that you like us, feel that it's the language of the heart. It brings us together, unites us. At a time when the world is really divided, we need music, and we need the people that love music, the soulful people, the people that can go out and lift up people's spirits. Don't be afraid to sing, even if you sing average. You know, sing. Sing to people. Make music. If you play an instrument, even badly, play. Go and find old people's homes. Go where the broken are and play music to them. Because when I look at you and you look at us, I realize that beyond color and beyond creed, we are one nation under the groove. Peace. Sing with me. One love. One love.
One love.
Incognito.